name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Wonderful to be here and to gather round this altar to sing the praises of God and to thank Him for 150 years of this parish church, thanking Him for all the graces, for all the favours that have been given because of this church. So with our hearts full of joy, we try to raise now our minds up to God, and we ask Him to help us to celebrate as worthily as we can. First of all, to forgive whatever may need to be forgiven in our lives. So we pray now for a moment in silence. Now we say together, I confess. Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. God our Father, you have revealed the mysteries of your word through St. John the Apostle. By prayer and reflection, may we come to understand the wisdom he taught. Grant this to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Something which has existed since the beginning, that we have heard and we have seen with our own eyes, that we have watched and touched with our own hands, the Word who is life. This is our subject. That life was made visible. We saw it and we are giving our testimony, telling you of the eternal life which was with the Father and has been made visible. What we have seen and heard, we are telling you, so that you too may be in union with us. We are in union with the Father and with his Son, Jesus Christ. We are writing this to you to make our own joy complete. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you. We praise you, O God. We acknowledge you to be the Lord. The glorious company of the apostles praise you, O Lord. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. On the first day of the week, Mary of Magdala came running to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one Jesus loved. "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb," she said, "and we don't know where they have put him." So Peter set out with the other disciple to go to the tomb. They ran together, but the other disciple, running faster than Peter, reached the tomb first. He bent down and saw the linen clothes lying on the ground, but did not go in. Simon Peter was following now, came up and went into the tomb, saw the linen clothes on the ground, and also the cloth that had been over his head. This was not the linen cloth, but rolled up in a place by itself. Then the other disciple, who had reached the tomb first, also went in. He saw, and he believed. And this is the Gospel of the Lord.
Wonderful to see the Word of God, the Gospels, brought up so beautifully today by these young people, showing great dignity, showing gracefulness. And perhaps by their dancing and their movement, but that way reminding us of the importance of God's Word. So thank you for what you've done for us this evening. It was lovely. It's always a joy and a privilege to be able to speak about St. John, your patron. After all, he was a very special friend of our Lord. He referred to himself as the beloved disciple. And we heard that a moment ago. And he was often with our Lord on very special occasions. Great moment when our Lord was transfigured. John was there with Peter and with James. And then at the moment of great crisis for our Lord, when he was in the Garden of Gethsemane, his agony, John was there too, with Peter, with James. But he was the only one of the apostles who didn't run away, when the great crisis came. He was there, standing with Our Lady at the foot of the cross. And you remember how it was to him that the words of our Lord were addressed, "Son, behold thy mother," and to Our Lady, "Woman, behold thy son." It is traditional that he looked after Our Lady after that, when he was living at Ephesus. But of course, at that moment, St. John was representing all of us, and all of us, through St. John, being committed to the special care of Mary, our mother. So it's a marvelous thing for a parish to have St. John as patron. And surely we know that he's taking a very special interest in all of us tonight. And we heard from one of his letters this evening, and we heard from his gospel, two very important statements. What we have seen and heard, we are telling you, so that you too may be in union with us.